Russian President Putin issues a warning to the West as reports of a Russian buildup continuing near Ukraine. Germany struggling with their mission to free itself of its dependency on petroleum. And I want to talk about water on Mars. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. It's December 24th. Got the date right this time. December 24th, 2021. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. Okay, first Ukraine. Russian President Putin had a press conference, an annual news conference, end of year news conference, and he basically said the ball is in NATO's court. It's up to the United States and NATO when it comes to what happens next, because he said that Russia needs certain guarantees. They can de-escalate the situation if NATO and the U.S. gives certain guarantees. For example, if NATO agrees not to expand its military resources into Ukraine, if NATO agrees not to install offensive weapons in a region close to Russia. And really, Russia, from their perspective, they just want to protect their own national interests. They don't want offensive weapons that close to their border, that close to their population centers. I can't blame them. I can't blame them on that. And it seems to me that the U.S. is using NATO to project this force in Ukraine. They're using NATO because here's how it works. NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization, is basically US, UK, Germany, France, a bunch of European countries forming an alliance in case, you know, the Soviet Union, which no longer exists, or in this case, Russia attacks them. They can protect one another. And Europe benefits from this greatly. The United States contributes a significant amount of resources, military resources, to NATO. And the whole idea is countering Russian forces, Russian influence, power. Well, in recent decades, NATO has been projecting its power, its influence out east. And the United States has really, I think, is really driving a lot what's going on in Ukraine, because if the Ukrainian people want to join NATO, that is their right. However, they have to face the consequences of doing such a thing, and that's creating a security problem with Russia. If the people don't want that, then you got to ask yourself, okay, what are the forces in Ukraine pushing us towards war with Russia? You know, I mean, because I'm not really convinced that the Ukrainian people really want this type of war. I don't think they're not going to benefit from this at all. And I hope cooler heads prevail. There was a Reuters report. They actually use a U.S. company, their satellite footage. They claim that there's been an increase in Russian forces, Russian military forces in Crimea and around the Ukraine-Russian border. And they're claiming that the Russians are putting in more forces around that area. The thing is, this company, Maxar, is a U.S. company. So you don't really know if they have a certain agenda, since there's certain U.S. interests who are pushing us towards this, and it hasn't been independently verified. So that's really important to mention. A lot of you guys criticized some of my sources in my last video, and that's fair enough. CNN, New York Times, they've been wrong before. Thing is, I like to use some type of source. So, you know, I'm not just making everything up, and if something turns out to be wrong, then I'll definitely acknowledge that. I've been wrong before. I've made mistakes, so I have no problem acknowledging that. But yeah, if you can come up with much better sources, please let me know. I appreciate that. I understand that there's a lot of baby boomers who are being negatively impacted by what's going on in the economy. A lot of these people are having a hard time finding jobs because they hit a certain age and people don't want to hire them. A lot of people are leaving because they don't want the you-know-what in the arm. So they're saying, the heck with this, you know. But we got some serious issues. Millennials, a lot of them, we're not able to get into the workforce and gain enough experience before a lot of these baby boomers left. And what that means is, you know, you're going to have a lot of millennials who don't have the same experience, and we're going to see some type of challenges. Millennials unable to do the same job at the level that we need them to be able to actually do it. I remember when I came out of college, I wanted to become a pro officer, but I was fresh out of college, and it wasn't a lot of positions, and it wasn't a lot of people leaving their jobs. It wasn't a lot of people retiring. People stayed at those jobs for a long time, and I'm not blaming them. They got kids to take care of as well. But, you know, I had to compete with boomers, with people with decades of experience. And we have a limited amount of jobs. That's a big, big challenge. Anyway, speaking of big challenges, Germany, they rely on natural gas, they rely on coal, they rely on nuclear, but they're going away from all that. Well, at least that's the plan. By 2030, they want to completely be free of coal plants, coal energy. By 2040, I think they're going to be done with natural gas. Actually, sooner than that. What's interesting is that half the homes in Germany are heated up by natural gas. But they're getting to the point where they want to, in a matter of years, they want to get to the point where, I think in the next 5 or 6 years, they want to make sure that no new insulations for homes will be geared towards petroleum heating systems. So they want to go from natural gas, essentially, to heat pumps. Heat pumps use the energy off the grid. The question is, will they have a grid that's reliable enough to really support all that in that big population? Because solar and wind can be a bit, not as dependable as nuclear. In fact, they're going to shut down 3 nuclear plants this year. I think this year or next year in Germany, nuclear plants are going to be shut down. They're going to shut down. They're going to have another 3. They're going to shut down a year after that. So they're going to be free of nuclear energy. But I think they rely on nuclear and coal for like 40% of their energy right now. There's around half or so. It's just a lot. 40, it's a lot. So they're going to have to get their renewable energies game up in a big, big way. And a conflict with Russia is not going to help the situation, that's for sure, because they rely on Russia from a lot of energy to heat their homes. But they're going to try to get free of that pretty soon. I wish them luck. Looking forward. Oh, Mars. They actually found, scientists believe they found proof that there's water, hydrogen, a lot of hydrogen, but particularly water in the Grand Canyon, so to speak, the Mars's Grand Canyon. And they're convinced that about 40% of the near surface is pretty much covered or has a lot of water in it, which is pretty awesome. So if they actually have a mission to Mars, this could be really helpful if they have water. I don't know if they're going to have life. They may have single-cell organisms. They may have bacteria. I don't know what they're going to have on Mars. But water will make it easier for humans to set up a colony. They may have to set up a colony pretty close to that area. We'll see how that really develops. So thank you guys for watching my channel. Thank you for supporting me all year. All you new people, welcome. I try to provide a perspective from somebody who, I mean, we're all biased because we all have experiences, but I try to look at things as objectively as I can and just say, hey, this is the reality we have to deal with, whether I like it or not. So that's what I try to do on this channel. And I'm gonna be talking more about current events. I wanna share this with you guys. Share your thoughts on what you think is going to happen with Russia and Ukraine. And why do you think there's such a push for the U.S., for people in the U.S. or some people in NATO to project that power into Ukraine? Do you think people are trying to start a war? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.